Good evening, everyone. My name is Bruce Swartz. I'm from Montreal, Quebec. For those who didn't get a chance to see it, I'm going to take just a minute to show these. Actually, I didn't show this photo. It's of the blood moon that just went by, the Wolf Super Blood Moon. It was minus 33 degrees Celsius, and it was during a snowstorm, so that's why you could see it's actually blurry and that you can't really see as much details of the craters itself. But a blood moon, just to give you guys an idea of why we're seeing it red, they say it's the phenomenon whereby the moon in total eclipse appears reddish in color as it is illuminated by the sunlight as it's filtering and refracting through Earth's atmosphere. And that's what is said as we observe this beautiful phenomenon. Now we're going to talk Sirius UFO firing 360 degrees around it. The big circle is around a UFO, and around this UFO, hundreds of lights are going left and right. I'm going to try to pinpoint as many as you can. There's a group right there in the circle on the left. You'll see it fly all the way to the bottom left, bottom right. There we go, there on the top left. There's a light there and there. So it's scattering. They're taking off. And listen, that craft, the big one that you see that's lit up, that remains lit up, it does ignite. It lights up when these lights are coming from it. It's shooting out lights 360 degrees out of itself while it remains in a stationary position, guys. So this is very, very real. And I want to, you know, I can't specify enough on what we're looking at right now. On the lights are going elsewhere. It's not just a light on the surface. You know, because that's what many people are going to think. I slowed it down a lot. Do you see it igniting up? It's flaring up. That UFO is flaring up as these objects are leaving it. Not just one object. The sphere is sitting right. It's being produced from the inside of this light. And they're being shot out on the surface of the moon. I'm very serious. Look at the fleet that's going to appear right in the circle here. Boom. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are coming from that light. It's shooting out lights. Could it be a big mothercraft ship shooting out other little scout crafts? Now, this is hard to do, guys. Please be patient. Look at this. One light there. Keep watching. One light there. Keep watching. Those lights there. Now watch how intensified the light gets. There it is. It beamed up. A light's going to appear right beside it. And it's going to shoot out. And then they're going to appear just off to the left. Watch the end of the UFO, the one on the right. And watch what goes towards the arrow. You saw it. It's a line. Because something was shot out of that light or UFO that's going through, cutting through this cloud or haze. That's something else that's very important that many are not noticing. Look carefully. You'll see the line. Boom, there it is. And you see it shooting out something of the UFO. Some exquisite views of the UFOs on the surface, and I really, really love sharing them with you. But around these UFOs, there are shooting lights that are coming out of them. And I want more people to get interested in this because it's something psychotically crazy when you think of it. Not only did I find a UFO on the surface of the moon, but I'm finding one that's interacting. It looks intelligent, like it's an intelligent species. How can that be? If there are no humans on the moon, how can there be a UFO up there flying around in clouds? And that is literally what we're looking at. It's the most beautiful finding, I think, in the entire history of all findings, is finding out that this big secret of having an inhabited moon or some active being up there, or maybe even possibly creatures. Look at the texturing here. I love it. You can see the clouds so well in the background. It's just a straight up shot. Hard to believe for many that there are clouds on the surface. But now here's the thing. The UFOs that I am capturing on the surface of the moon, guys, are different. Okay, never mind the meteors. This is what I'm trying to tell you guys. One guy told me, have you seen the video recently? Somebody caught a meteorite during the blood moon. Now, I'm not discrediting that person who says that he got it. Not a problem. But look at all the flashing lights that I'm showing you guys. I want people to understand that the flashing lights are not bloody meteors. They're an inhabited surface of thousands, possibly thousands, of these crafts that are, you know, they're buzzing around up there, guys. Look carefully. This is something flying by that is actually changing directions. It's going east and is now going to go down, travel south. Now, I've been listening in the UFO community, and everything everyone wants is directional changes, UFOs like this, and I'm showing the proof. It's out there. I'm vouching for every ufologist who's ever tried to show anyone some truth in ufology. World, it's very real. Look at this, a directional change. So that means there's an object on the moon doing a directional change. And what's amazing about that, guys, is that it rules out spots on the screen. It rules out satellites, okay? So it's not. So now we're talking about something that's not an asteroid, that's not a satellite, and that's not a spot on a screen. What is it? It's a UFO, an intelligent being that is either driving these, either through remote control, or they're inside of the craft. If that's a vessel, it's being driven by someone. And who is driving them? And how come there are more than one? And these lights that are coming out, like you just saw there again, lights. I've showed hundreds of lights here. I've showed explosions on the surface. Look at them. What lights are coming out of these objects? But let me tell you, those lights travel after. They go all over the surface like scout crafts. I would not be surprised if that is real, a scout craft. You hear in the movies that the mothership will land and all these little scout crafts come out. Why do you think we're talking about that? Because it's maybe a part of a certain reality. What do you want those lights to be? It'd be a lot more reassuring for me to think that there's someone driving inside of those lights than some type of nuclear bombing freak creature. I mean, what the hell is it? Is the surface of the moon being bombed? I think I have enough proof and evidence to theorize or wonder about that, to assume that we're looking at a bloody UFO on the surface that is spitting out lights 360 degree angle around the craft. Look at the quantity of lights that were shot out or that left that light. There must be at least 20 or 30 there in the haze. Now, I noticed some of them are creating their own smokes right behind them. Whatever it may be, I see them cutting through clouds. Here are three lights that lit up. Everyone's flipping out for that meteorite or the meteor. Yeah, the meteorite that hit, the flash or something on the moon. I just showed you three that lit up and two more right beside it. So that's five flashes in a slowed down footage of 3 seconds. So don't tell me that it's meteors. Please. Don't even make me laugh, because if it's meteors, that means that these five meteors you're looking at right now are going to crash on the moon. They're not meteors, and you know it. That's for sure. Triangular formation going east, another UFO going downwards, and another one in the bottom right traveling in another direction. The proof is all there. This is with the Nikon D850 camera. Guys, we're going to find an amazing view of all the different types of UFOs on the surface. I'm already starting up the collection, getting some pictures up on Facebook. For those of you who want to join me on Facebook, make it fast. 5,000 people is the maximum people they hold on Facebook for a page, and I'm already up over 1,000, and they're coming in fast. So if you guys want to join me and follow me on Facebook, as I also share my research there, but don't worry. If you're on YouTube, that's the best place you got to be if you want to follow my research, because I'm really involved right here on YouTube. And I'm thanking YouTube to get a chance to be able to share this with you guys. You know, it's incredible. Many years ago, before the internet, I wouldn't have been able to share this with all of you unless I, you know, made a DVD, a video or something like that. So this is a straight up raw truth mini documentary. I couldn't have called it anything else. Beautiful proof. How about this? Flying in formation, the real thing. Three UFOs flying in triangular, perfect, military-like triangular formation going across the surface of the moon. This one gives me chills. I love it. Because how lucky can somebody be to plunge in under clouds and to find UFOs on an entire planet or moon? Let me tell you, there's lots of them. Because it's literally impossible, seems to me, to plunge into clouds on an unknown planet or moon and to find UFOs immediately in front of your camera. Slowing it down, adjusting the contrast, sharpening the image, enhancing the image, you're not going to see the crafts unless they're enhanced. That's just the way it is, and that is exactly why people are not seeing these. It's not hundreds of thousands of people that catch UFOs, aside from the fake videos. I don't know which ones are fake, because obviously I have no proof of anyone making fake UFO videos, but this is the best I can do, and that's what UFO looks like. The military posted a UFO, and whenever they do, and even the CIA, and whenever they show any secret UFO or craft, it's always a cloud or a dark craft or a blur. You guys know it, and that's always what we're seeing. Well, a jam-packed video, lots of stuff in this video. I also want to go to the Apollo 17 moon landing. I'm really happy, guys. This is the area. We're going to the Taurus Littoral Valley area, and we're going to go see where they declared having landed and look at the amazing surface on Mare Serenitatis. And that's where the Littoral Valley is. It's just off of Mare Serenitatis. There's Posidonius crater just below that. Let's take a look at that. We're going to get in so close. We're going to see so many amazing things. I'll be looking at the Apollo 11 moon landings this week, UFO research, and a lot more to come. Thanks for watching the research. Disclosure does not have to go through the media. It does for some because they have that need that they need it to be front page news for them to believe it. If you're a smart enough person and you're able to distinguish whether I'm, being honest or not, I'm sure you will find interest in the research that I'm doing, and you will see that the overall surface that I'm showing is very real. Where they landed, there's a connection or bridge-like object towering that goes all the way up the ridge here, thousands of feet, and it's connected to the center of Mare Serenitatis over to the left there, which is Bessel Crater. I'll get a circle up over it and show you the direction of that line that goes up to here from Bessel Crater.